World heavyweight champion Mark Fleming, welcome to the Carolinas, Mark.
Oh, I'm so excited to be here in the North American Wrestling Association. I'm ready to wrestle all comers. I won the International World Heavyweight title here in the States. I've been traveling to Japan, Australia, defending my title, and I'm so happy to be here and give anybody a shot here at this title. I'll be glad to do it in the square circle.
I'm going to tell you what, there's a lot of tradition that goes with that championship belt, and you know what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir, I do. Six-time world champion Lou Thesz held this belt. Ed Stringer Lewis, Jim Lundis, all the greats you can think of in the past, true wrestlers, and I am so honored to hold this. And I'm going to do everything and give 150% in defending this belt every time I get in the ring.
Speaking of the living legend, we'd like to welcome him on board right now. Can we have a nice hand for the living legend, Lou Thesz? Champ, it's a pleasure having you here in the North American Wrestling Association.
Well, thank you very much, Ted. I'm very happy to be here. Saw some fine wrestling here tonight. And when you see Mark Fleming go to post, well, I think you're going to see some more of it.
Well, I tell you, he's got a tremendous tradition to uphold by wearing the strap that you held for a long time.
Well, he won in the tournament, and it belongs to him now. And the championship will be perpetuated on to the next one that beats him. But it'll be interesting to see. It's going to take a great wrestler because I'm mightily impressed with this man's ability.
Holding up one heck of a tradition, Johnny.
And as the announcer alluded to, Lou Thesz has held it seven times, and he was the master. I had a lot of rough matches with Lou Thesz. He was the king.
No doubt about it. And this fellow, Mark Fleming, is certainly a tremendously built fellow, a tremendous ability, a lot of power, and a guy that is certainly worthy of the title. When he heard about the activity happening in the North American Wrestling Association, he made his reservation and said, count me in. That's another strap he'd like to hold down the road.
And, of course, Lou Thesz, to be honored by the presence of him on the program is a real honor, and NAWA Wrestling is certainly glad to have Lou Thesz here. Now, this Mark Fleming, we're going to see a lot of Lou Thesz. Lou Thesz is in Mark Fleming. Lou Thesz is a great champion, a real wrestler, and we're seeing a lot of wrestling there. A basic moves by Mark Fleming.
David Smith looks like a guy that has tested Domino's Pizza's 30-minute time limit several times in his life.
That was a fine wing lock and the takedown with the head scissors by Mark Fleming, and that was a patented Lou Thesz maneuver. Here's going to switches it now, switches over to figure four.
He's got that grapevine on that arm. It applies the pressure. The referee, Ron West, checking. He's applying the pressure heavy right now. This is probably the first time David Sledge has had the bridge in a long time, Johnny.
Probably the first time David Sledge ever had a figure four wrist lock put on him. And Mark Fleming has got it down. Another patented move of Lou Thesz.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's the one thing about the North American Wrestling Association. You are going to see some wrestling maneuvers that many of you have not seen in years.
A great wrestling hold. It's been a long time since we saw three or four on the arm like that.
Sledge finds the ropes, and Ron West calls for the break. Fleming with an arm drag takedown and right back to work on that arm.
Did you see the aggressiveness of Fleming? He didn't give Sledge a time to get up and get a breath. He was right in there with a great arm drag takedown, and he's going to hold him down on the mat. And once again, here's the man, Mark Fleming, giving up several pounds to David Sledge, and he's going to keep him on the mat with a bullfist thing.
The International Heavyweight Champion in action today here on the North American Wrestling Association, Mark Fleming with Lou Thesz in his corner. I'm Ted Webb, my partner, Johnny Weaver, bringing you the excitement of the best in professional wrestling. We're at ringside, and we're watching a master at work right now.
And we certainly are in Mark Fleming, and under the wing of tutelage of Lou Thesz. You can see a lot of Thesz in the moves that he makes. And he spoke of the bridge of David Sledge. It's all he's been doing to keep them shoulders off the mat because Fleming is really heading close. Look at him tie him up here.
Well, I got to tell you, we're getting some great camera angles from the action at ringside, and we'd like to thank our director, Randy Belk, for some great work this evening.
You know, Fleming's a big boy, around 260 pounds. He moves like a cat in there. Just the conditioning of these athletes in the NAWA amazes me, like Torelli and Bo Reagan in the first match we saw, and now Mark Fleming.
And don't forget former Mr. North Carolina, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, who stays in great shape. He's got that gym in Charlotte.
Oh, it's always a pleasure for every wrestling fan throughout the world to see Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Mr. North Carolina, 1982 to be exact. Right about now, David Sledge has realized that he is completely out-talented in the ring, outmatched in the ring, searching the manual right now to see if he could find an escape maneuver for some of the maneuvers that are put on by Mark Fleming, the international heavyweight champion.
It looks to me like his sledge really doesn't know where he's at. He's never been in there with a wrestler for the condition or the knowledge of Mark Fleming.
And you know, Johnny, the further we get into the match, the more that conditioning comes into play.
It certainly does, and it has really baffled David Sledge. He hasn't been able to mount any kind of an offense because I don't think he's ever seen the offense throw that in like Mark Fleming has done.
And I tell you right now, it's been all Fleming. And Fleming is back looking at the race as David Sledge. Sledge right now looking for a gas station, and there is none in the ring.
Fleming really wore him down with that conditional payoff.
Fleming going in for the pin, 1-2, and barely beating the count of three as David Sledge.
He's just able to get that one shoulder off the mat. Mark Fleming almost put him away right there. Oh, reversal! Reversal by Sledge!
This on our slow motion instant replay. Johnny, I want you to describe this because this is a beauty to watch.
Fleming hasn't really set up right here, but Mark David Sledge makes a desperate maneuver, but it's reversed because off the rope with that flying body press was Mark Fleming, and it's all over.
And that is the count of three, and don't go away because we've got lots more coming up of the North American Wrestling Association, including a visit.